Hi, this is JC with Route4Me. Who do we have on the call?
Hi, JC. My name is Steven. How's it going today?
Pretty good. And you, Steve?
I'm doing quite well.
Fantastic. I understand. Do you have some questions about your trial?
Yeah, JC. I started a 7-day trial on my own, I tried to figure out how it was best to set up a dispatch account to really help figure out my drivers and how I could assign them to routes and really just see the tracking I want to be able to see reportings as well. It's really important to me to understand what my drivers are doing and to make sure they're efficiently using their time. And I was told that Route4Me could really help me out with that.
All right. That shouldn't be a problem. The first thing we need to do is make sure that we create a dispatch process, okay? An efficient dispatch process that will help you plan faster routes, you know, have your drivers with the information ready to go, and, you know, send them on their way, okay? So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to create a dispatcher in your team section, okay? So on the left-hand side, when you log in into your Route4Me account, you see the team section. You see it right there?
Yep.
Okay. So we're going to click on that, and we're going to go to users. So once we're in their users section, all you have to do is just add a sub-user. See, in this account, I'm the administrator, so I'm just going to go to the right-hand side and click on add sub-users. Then from here, we just simply need to name it. So let's call it dispatch 1. Let's do the 1 here. Something like this, okay? And we're going to call it dispatch at route4me.com. Then set up a password. And a user type will be dispatcher, okay?
Okay, great.
You can set up a phone number, the state, where they work, maybe they're remote workers, things like that. The user role options will allow you to give this dispatcher as much access as possible. Best practice indicates that you should leave it the way it is, because it, you know, a dispatcher should be able to go into the routes, view the global address book, see what the drivers are doing, be able to watch the tracking, all routes, new routes, you know, have access to all of that. But it's completely up to you. So you can make changes to the access and the role for that user as much as you can in here. Make sense?
Yep. Okay. So what if I wanted to hide all their future routes? Is that something you can do on here?
Yeah. So for example, see, hide non-future routes?
Yeah, it's right there.
Yes. There you go. Something like this. Okay. So like I said, you know, the best option is to leave it the way it is. We have it already preset up to best to do with a dispatcher with this level of access, but it's completely up to you. Okay?
Okay,
so
great.
Once we have this guide ready, we save the user or add user. And now the system is going to add it. There he is, our dispatcher. Now that we have a dispatcher, what we're going to do is we're going to go and plan a route. Okay? Now, there are multiple ways in which you can plan a route. You can actually use a file to upload. You can have a list of addresses. Let me show you a file like this. See? You can have a file with a list of addresses, alias, address. And right from here is where you're going to set up your time windows. Okay? What we need to do is just create 3 additional columns. Time window start. Oops. Time window start. And the time window end. Okay? Now, once we have these 3 columns, you start setting up your windows of opportunities. You use military time, and the time column will be used to determine how many minutes you're going to be at each stop. So it's the duration of the stop. For example, let's say this guy is going to take us 10 minutes. This guy is going to take us 5. This guy is going to take 15. And this guy is going to take 30. You get the idea?
Yep.
Excellent. So once we have this, then you can just go on and set up your time windows, let's say 8 a.m. to 10 a.m. Maybe this guy is 2 p.m. To 5 p.m. and that will make it the proper format for us to calculate your time windows. Okay? Don't worry about learning all these functionalities right now. I just want you to be able to test them. And then once you activate your account, we'll put you through onboarding, which are training sessions. And, you know, a routing specialist will sit down and do exactly what we're doing right now, only with your data, and we'll teach you how to use each functionality, okay? So it's just mainly what I want to accomplish is to show you how this works, okay?
Yep.
So this is all you have to do right from here, okay? So let's get rid of that because I don't want to create all those windows right now. But let's just go ahead and use this file. Go back to Route4Me, and we're going to go to Routes. It's always on the blue menu. You see that? Can look like this, or it will look like that.
Oh, great.
So plan your route. Then the system is going to ask you basically how are you going to input data into it. So you can type in the addresses, you can copy and paste, but since you have a file, which I will highly recommend that you have a file, you know, if you're going to type in the addresses, type them into a file, into an Excel file or CSV, so that you can later on upload it. It's the safest way to do it. Now, if you're just doing like a, I don't know, five-stop route or a 10-stop route, then yes, you can definitely type in the addresses, okay? So we're just going to go into upload a file. We're going to name this route. I'm just going to call it Steven. Schedule. And schedule the route. Let's say we're doing this tomorrow. Maybe they start at 8 a.m. We're going to create a service time. Now, if you're doing time windows and your file already has that time column, you can leave the service time in here empty because the system will prioritize the file. But if you do something in here, it will do it for all the stops. Okay? So let's say 10 minutes to stop. Then when you go to the optimization, this is where you can actually plan your routes. You can set up a single driver, multiple drivers, or you can balance the route. Now, this is the functionality where you will use time windows. You will set up a duration of the route and will tell the system how many drivers you need. You following me?
Yep.
So with this, the system will create a restriction and will say, okay, you don't need 10 drivers, you can do with 8 or you can do with 6. You know, the system will tell you exactly how many drivers you need based on those restrictions in the time windows. Since we're not going to use time windows right this moment, we're going to balance the route. And the balance will make sure that each driver gets almost the same amount of stops, but because of proximity, one driver might actually end up with more stops than the other based on how much of an area has they have to cover. Make sense?
Yep, that makes sense.
Excellent. So what we're going to do is just going to break this into 3 drivers. See if we can make that happen. Then create a, we're going to create a round trip, and we're going to plan the route. We're going to look for the addresses, which are right here. Let's go ahead and start right from here. Continue to review. Oh, wait. I'm going to go back.
Yeah, I don't think,
I don't think that's the I don't think that's the right file. Give me 1 second, see? To reroute CSV, make sure we got it saved in the right place.
Yeah, I was thinking, I was like, hey, you have a you have more than 5 addresses when you're showing me.
I know. Sorry about that. Oh, there it is. Let's see, save that. Let me try to find it again. 1 sec. Ah, there it is. It was hiding. There we go. Okay, here we go. Continue to review. Now the system will go through the validation process, okay? If you have addresses that don't, they're not geocoded 100%, you will review them here, okay? You just have to edit.
Okay.
Okay. So then just simply finish the import, and the system will go to work and plan our 3 routes at once. You see how fast and easy can that be?
Yep.
Dispatcher will be the one doing this. Excellent. All right, there we have it. Our three routes. Okay. Now we're going to set up all the markers so that we can see how the system broke it out into three different routes. You can see how one guy is going one way and the other two separate ways.
Yep.
Make sense?
Yep.
Definitely. Excellent. Excellent. So next thing we're going to do is we're going to assign a route. Okay, the next step in our dispatching processes is assign a route. So we're just going to go to assign user, and we're going to do we have driver? Driver one. Boom. Apply. You see that? Now, once you assign the route, we can go and perhaps we need to make changes to that route. Maybe it's the beginning of the day and some changes need to be applied. So all you have to do is just go and open the route. And from here, you can make multiple changes. You can actually add a stop. You can remove stops. You can change the way that you look at the route. You can change it or not. From here, let's say that for whatever reason I have to visit, I don't know, stop number 10 before I do number 1. Okay, maybe 10, since we plan a round trip as the driver has to come back, the system calculator was best for him to do this on the way back. So let's just say that you want this done at the beginning, but you don't want to change anything else. So all we have to do is just on the left-hand side, we grab that stop, we drag it, and we make it the first stop. Something like this.
Okay, great.
See what I did?
Yep.
Okay. From here, you have an activity feed. Our activity feed allows you to see what happens on the route. When the driver marks an address visited, when the driver makes a change, maybe when the driver adds a text note, drivers are able to collect pictures, sign on glass signatures, add videos, and voice notes as notes onto each stop. And when that happens, the activity feed on the right-hand side will show you everything that's going on. In fact, you can send messages to your drivers like this. It's like a text function that we have active in there.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Yep. Let me show you what the tracking will look like. Here, we're going to play a simulation of it.
Yep.
Yeah, make it pretty fast here. Click play. And there the driver goes. It's pretty far route. As you can see, let's just make it faster. There we go. I think that should do it. So as the driver stops at each location, it will create the record as to what was planned for the driver to, how much time was planned to spend there versus the reality of it. Okay. Now, can you see this? Do you have any questions?
No, not so far. It looks great.
Excellent. So within the route, you can actually insert and add more stops to it. You can just basically just type in an address and add it. And then once you add stops to this, you can go to the route section and re-optimize the route. Then again, going back to the tracking, like I said, the drivers with their mobile device, not only you're able to track them, but also are able to mark addresses visited and departed. We also include a geofence section, okay, a geofence functionality that will allow you to compare when the driver actually went into the stop and when he departed. It will do it automatically. It doesn't even need a driver interaction. The driver will pull in to stop number 5 into the circle, which you can change in diameter, or you can turn it into a square and change the size of it. You can customize it any way you want. So the driver will pull in, marks visited, and as the driver leaves, we'll mark it departed. What do you think?
Great. So how would that look on this address if he's marking it as visited and departed and making notes and taking pictures. Where is that going to show up?
That's going to show up right here. Let's say stop number 5. When you click on the stop, you'll see notes. And obviously, the driver will have the ability to disposition that note, create the actual, say, text of the note, and they'll be able to upload a picture, video, or signature. And you will see this. I'm just going to cancel this. You will see this in this section right here at the bottom. Okay?
Yep.
You'll be able to download the pictures directly from the website as the drivers upload them. Okay? It's almost instantaneous. All right? Now, let's go to the analytics section so that you can see what needs to be adjusted. We're going to go into the dashboard. And you can see how you can filter based on the periods, and you can see how many total routes were planned, how many stops, you know, the total planned miles and how many actual miles we covered. You know, we present it to you in a nice graphic way so that you can you know, have a lot of information for you to make your decisions. Not only that, but also in the analytics section, you can go into the activity feed. Okay, and you can filter activities by driver. You can even download it into a CSV. You can say, okay, show me what driver one it's been doing, and there we go, throughout multiple days. What do you think?
Yeah, it looks good.
Mm-hmm. Excellent. So based on the existing routing data, based on the analytics section, based on how you can go back to the routes and actually go look into a routes list, and you know, the dispatcher will take a look of all the routes. They can actually hover on top of one of the routes like this, wait for a few seconds, and then the route will show as a pop-up like this. Okay?
Yep.
And if the tracking is activated for all of the routes, I mean, when you activate your tracking, you should be able to see where your driver is in relation to the route live. Okay? You can also export the tracking history. When you go to export on the settings section for the route, you can just export the route. After it's done, you'll be able to export all of the data, all the metrics that were recorded throughout the route as the route progressed. You can do that, and you can also download the tracking history right here.
Okay, so what if I wanted to see all my drivers on the map at once? Is that something you guys can do?
Yeah, that's something that you can do, absolutely. All you have to do is just go into a routes map, and if you activate the tracking, you can just say track users, and then at that point, the system will show you, oh, look, one of our guys is using the app right now. You can see where everybody is on the map. What do you think?
Yeah, I think this is great. It was really helpful to actually be able to see this on my screen or on your screen, because I definitely was having some problems with it, just because I'm not really tech savvy. Yeah, I think that would really help out my company and my dispatchers to be able to...
Fantastic.
Yep, to be Fantastic. Able to see everything, definitely.
Excellent news, Steve. So what we need to do is basically activate your account. Let's just go ahead and skip the trial, because you already know the system will work. So let's go ahead and activate your account, set you up with your training sessions, set up your managers and your dispatchers so they can sit in and do the training sessions, and they can learn all the functionalities, okay? So let's go ahead and activate your account. I'll send you that email, and we'll activate that onboarding for you, okay?
Awesome. That sounds great, JC. Thank you very much.
Excellent, Steven. All right. I'll talk to you later, okay?
Yep. Bye-bye.
All right. Bye.